Everyone, my name is Elizabeth Bolander, and today I'm going to talk about the concept of othering. And this happens when you think of someone as different from yourself and you focus on those differences. This could be because of race, gender, national origin, and a host of other ways that we distinguish ourselves. But I want to talk about how I've seen othering and how people talk to and even teach students with differing abilities. In her video about the objectification of women, Jean Kilbourne talks about how women are dehumanized by images that show them as literally morphing into inanimate objects, and also just like shown as body parts, like a leg here, a breast there. According to her, this dehumanization encourages violence. And I think something similar goes on in education, where students who have differing abilities are seen as lesser and treated as different from their same age peers. I mean, how else would you justify showing preschool videos to high school students? And in doing so, teachers who are supposed to be committed to giving these students access to the general education curriculum are othering their students. And John Paul makes some profound remarks about parks versus forests. We fear forests because they are unpredictable and unruly, but we love parks, he says, because they're orderly and we can manipulate them to the way we want them to be. And I believe that same analogy can be applied to students with special needs. Many teachers place these students as other, and therefore they fear them. They're on edge, waiting for outbursts, some sort of health emergency to happen. And so they seek to dominate these children with special needs and control them. And one of the major ways they do that is by keeping them in certain educational settings. These children are victims of othering, where all the people involved view them by their differences and with a mindset of lack rather than focusing on the way they're similar. So as you can tell, I'm very passionate about students with differing abilities to be included in the general education curriculum. And one of the best ways that I can think of for this to finally become a reality is for universal design for learning. If all students have access to the same technology that makes accommodations for some students, then no one has to feel singled out or labeled as other, and everyone can benefit from these accommodations. For example, I think that Bookshare, which is a repository of books available in differing formats other than print, including braille files and audio files, I think that should be not be limited only to students with visual impairments and students with dyslexia, but should be available to all students because audio format and even braille can be useful for students who just simply learn differently. And the option to access materials in different ways should not be limited to one subset of students only. That would also take the stigma away from assistive technology because as the students get older, like their awkward teen years, they often don't want to use the technology because they're seeing themselves as different from everyone else because the other students don't use that technology. But if everyone had access to it, we would have a great reduction in the othering that we do to our students. So thank you for listening. I hope that we can chat about othering and the ways that you've seen othering also.